Bulgaria is located in the extreme southeast of Europe, a country of natural splendor, fairy tale-like villages, ancient ruins, and monasteries with remarkable frescoes. And a culture that's between both Orient and Occident. Dobre došli! Welcome to God's front garden. Welcome to paradise. Sofia, the wise woman, and since 1879, capital of the new Bulgaria. A city whose roots date back to the 5th century BC. It has a long history. Once Thracians settled here, then followed Romans, Goths, Huns and Ottomans. At the end of the 19th century, the city's appearance changed from Oriental to European. Into a dynamic metropolis, a multicultural capital with a Western imprint that unites all. Sofia's historic city centre features the most splendid sacred building in the Balkan Peninsula of the 20th century, the Aleksandâr Nevski Cathedral. A work of art of the Russian Orthodox religion that can accommodate a congregation of more than 5,000. The monumental features continue within. And here also the abundance of shape and colour help to temper the otherwise overwhelming scene. The most famous Russian and Bulgarian masters of the turn of the century are represented here with icons, wall paintings and mosaics. That is why the wooden carvings, reliefs, ornaments, and wall paintings are among the most beautiful of their kind. A masterpiece of national rebirth. In the shadow of the mighty cathedral, a stone lion guards the city's oldest Christian church, Sveta Sofia. The exterior of this modest red brick building is in stark contrast to the splendid, shining icons on the plain brick walls of its interior. Above it, a basilica was built, but soon after it was completed, it was destroyed by the Goths, and later a larger one replaced it. It seems as though the city's patron saint, Sofia, cared for the maintenance of her church. The Red Army Memorial is a reminder of Russian aid and liberation from foreign rule. Dramatic symbols of true socialism. Borisova Gradina is the name of the surrounding park, the city's largest, created by a Swiss landscape designer. With the huge monolith of the liberators, small lakes, and the Orlov Most Eagle Bridge. Beside it is Sveti Nikolai, the Russian church. The inner courtyard of one of the city's best and most expensive hotels contains the remains of Sveti Georgi, a rotunda of red brick with a dramatic history. It dates back to the 4th century and first served as a Roman place of culture before it was consecrated as the Church of St. George in the 6th century AD. Close by is the Sveta Nadelia Church, or Holy Sunday Church. The peaceful gleam of the splendid icons of the interior of this, one of the city's most important churches, hides a bloody event of bygone times. On the 16th of April 1925, there was an assassination attempt on Tsar Boris. The Tsar survived uninjured. However, 120 people were killed and 500 badly injured. The church domes were destroyed by the explosion. The seat of the president is located within a grey 20th century building. By their colourful uniforms, the guards add colour and life. Day and night, they guard the main entrance of the presidential palace. And the changing of the guard ceremony is a popular attraction. The guards goose-step dressed in red and white parade uniforms. With its plum-shaped domes and striking minaret, the Banyabasi Mosque can be seen from afar. It is said to be the most important building of the Ottoman period. It is the only fully intact mosque that the city's Muslims possess. The hot springs of mineral water in the center of the city attracted the Romans, who built baths here. The Ottomans enlarged the complexes. Opposite the mosque and baths is the central market hall that dates back to the same period. The first roofed marketplace in Bulgaria is an impressive building of Art Nouveau design. Iron pillars support the first floor arcades as well as the roof. Close to the market hall is a Jewish religious building, the largest synagogue in the Balkan Peninsula, designed by an Austrian. The chandelier weighs 2,250 kilos and is the synagogue's pride and joy. And its main dome is 30 meters high. The Jewish community originated from Sephardim and settled here after their expulsion from Spain. The transformation of Sofia into a lively, cosmopolitan capital has succeeded well, with history and tradition still very much in evidence. Young, modern, and exciting, with the flair of the mystical Balkans. In a suburb of Sofia, located on the slopes of the Vitosha Mountains, is the country's most worshipped in historic building, Boyana Church. It comprises three churches that over the centuries have become a single entity. Within a small cemetery alongside the church, noblemen and dignitaries were laid to rest. The wall paintings within Boyana Church are a unique highlight of Bulgaria's medieval religious art. They form part of a small number of well-preserved works of art of the East Church that date back to the Latin period of the 13th century. The frescoes feature saints, angels, and motifs of biblical history, plus scenes that depict Jesus and his apostles. Unusually, the artists of Boyana expressed the feelings and thoughts of the people of that time. The style is of the medieval method of painting, as permitted by Byzantine art, along with traditional features. It's believed that there were three painting epochs, the 11th, 13th, and 16th centuries. The restorers estimate that there are around 240 paintings yet to be discovered. Because the paintings are very fragile, only a few visitors are allowed to enter the church at any one time and for a fixed period only. But the remarkable nature of these works of art makes it well worth a visit. The rocky landscape of Belogradchik appears like a mystic fairy tale landscape, especially when it's foggy. Fabulous red rock formations inspire the imagination. On the highest summits, the Romans, Bulgarians, and Ottomans built fortresses. About 200 million years ago, the sea receded from this area, and the sandy ground comprised of minerals and mud became bunter. Over the course of time, the forces of erosion formed these bizarre rock formations, and they were given colourful names. The northwest of Bulgaria is a wild mountain landscape of endless forests. It's hardly surprising that the Kaleto Fortress was never captured. The craggy mountains are in stark contrast to the nearby river landscape of the Danube. Vidin is still dominated by the Baba Vida Fortress, whose impressive towers and bastion date back to the 13th century. On the banks of the Danube, the northwestern entrances to the medieval realm were strictly controlled. The fortress protected it from invasion by ship. What can be seen of the fortress today was due to the Ottomans at the beginning of the 18th century, but much of the original building is also visible. In the 10th century, Bulgarian master builders began its construction at the location of a Roman watchtower. The city itself is a combination of various architectural styles. And the romantic atmosphere of the Danube promenade changes suddenly into the hustle and bustle of the city center. The mighty Sveti Dimitar Cathedral impresses by way of its fine external facade and tall, onion-shaped domes, plus its interior. A valuable wall of icons and rich wall paintings demonstrate the faith and wealth of a city whose citizens ousted its Ottoman rulers. Bulgaria's only gateway to the world lies on the Danube. The city of Rusa is the center of the northeast and a harbor for Middle Europe. Once many traders passed by here on their way to Constantinople. And at the time of the Austrian imperial monarchy, the city became an important junction. This is demonstrated by its architecture. Beautiful Art Nouveau buildings are everywhere. That is why Rusa was also known as Little Vienna. The city centre, with its ostentatious Austro-Hungarian architecture, indicates the wealth of bygone times. European flair in a Bulgarian-Romanian border town. The city's origins date back to a Roman settlement that was called the City of 60 Ships and protected the border of the Roman Empire. Later followed Avars and Ottomans, but its largest transformation came with the international agreement concerning free merchant shipping on the Danube. The city's appearance changed into one of both European and cosmopolitan influence, and the Danube became an important economic force. Near Rusa is the Ruzensky Lom Nature Park, a wild landscape with canyons, forests, and caves. The cave churches of Ivanovo were cut out of the limestone by hermit monks of the 11th century. They're now a UNESCO World Heritage Site. The realistic-looking wall paintings were a highlight of medieval art. They feature stories from the Passion, and they're a reminder of works of the later early Renaissance. Bulgaria's Black Sea coast is extremely popular with holidaymakers. We commence our visit in the northern Balchik. The Romanian queen, Maria, had her summer residence built here. And Bulgaria maintained this successful symbiosis as a museum. It has a shining white tower in the shape of a minaret that can be seen from far and wide. Directly above the sandy beach is the botanical garden that is one of the city's main attractions. It was originally planned to be a palace garden. Numerous labyrinth-like paths lead to a small Orthodox chapel that was dismantled in Crete and rebuilt here. More than 3,000 species of plants from all parts of the globe were planted here by Italian and Swiss landscape gardeners. The Aller's Garden contains a huge collection of cacti. It features more than 250 species. Further south, we visit Varna, the biggest city on the Black Sea coast, one of Europe's oldest cities. The golden shining domes of the impressive cathedral in Varna's city centre are one of its main landmarks. Bulgaria's second largest church is a copy of the Mother of God of Kazan Basilica in Petersburg. Its interior is dominated by a central dark wood iconostasis that was created in 1912 by Macedonian craftsmen from Debar. The Neo-Byzantine wall painting was completed in 1950 under Russian artist supervision. The colourful windows followed later. The carved bishop's throne with its two winged panthers seems to unite the three altars, accompanied by colourful paintings of saints. The building's superb acoustics can be experienced during Sunday service when the male choir sings. In spite of its age, the city is neither old-fashioned nor conservative, but full of joie de vivre. Historic Varna was founded in the 6th century BC and was then known as Odessos. Greeks came from Milet and built the first trading post in this location. Because of its strategically favorable location, the Romans liked it. They discovered the region's legendary hot springs and built thermal baths here. Even the ruins indicate the former dimensions of the buildings. Numerous rooms and halls, sections of a drainage system and water basins, as well as the remains of an ancient heating system, have been discovered here. For two centuries, the ritual of Roman bathing created a clean and relaxing atmosphere. For the Romans, Varna also became a political and administrative center and enjoyed much prosperity. Eight kilometers long, the park situated along the coast is said to be the largest complex of its kind in Europe. Indeed, it's a popular meeting point until late in the evening. Festivals and concerts take place here, and people also relax beneath the trees. At the edge of the park is a dolphinarium, the only one of its kind in the Balkans. Dolphins jump and play with colourful balls. And overwhelm onlookers with skillful tosses of the ball and clever acrobatic performances. Varna is the pearl of the Black Sea. For many years it's been a very popular resort, and its beaches are still a favorite holiday destination among Bulgarians. Every kind of water sport is available here, and it's a paradise for sunbathers. There's always something to see. A paradise of sun, sea, and the perfect beach, and above, the azure blue sky. Further south along the Black Sea coast and located on a peninsula is the historic town of Nesebar, an historic gem. For more than 5,000 years, Thracians, Byzantines, Romans and Ottomans settled here, until finally tourism came too. Small cobblestone alleys are framed by well-maintained buildings that date back to the Bulgarian Renaissance. These closely packed buildings with wooden and limestone facades and tiny balconies are mainly used for tourism. Souvenir stalls dominate the small squares and tangled alleys. In the summer months, the main holiday season, the old town simply bursts at the seams. It's believed that in its high season, up to 80 churches were built on the small peninsula, but today there are just a few remains. Today, the churches of bygone times bring the town's history to life, still in evidence, but not completely destroyed. To avoid destruction, the town capitulated. While those Orthodox churches that are still in use look modest from the outside, their interiors are surprisingly beautiful. The power of the paintings fascinates the faithful, as though they mark the presence of a divine spirit. The remains of the Christus Pantocrator Church boast a striking facade. It contains a row of arches alternately built of stone and brick. The impressive evidence of a long ecclesiastical history is used today as an art gallery, well cared for. The Johannes the Baptist Church dates back to the 19th century, a church constructed of natural stone with a central tower. Nesebar has the largest concentration of churches in Bulgaria. The reason why it has been designated by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site. Although during Ottoman occupation the town was not destroyed, it gradually fell into oblivion. Since independence, it has enjoyed a new high season. Today, Nesebar is a cultural treasure and a popular coastal resort. An old windmill and the remains of the ancient town wall are in good condition. Within this area, the cultures of several millennia unite with the common comforts of modern-day tourism. The southernmost coastal city of our journey is Sozopor, a jewel on the Black Sea. Not only a coastal resort, but also an old and fascinating city. In the 1990s, it was still a secret from outsiders, but today tourism has taken hold and now adds to its prosperity. The former summer resort of numerous Bulgarian poets and artists has much romantic flair, as well as the wooden architecture of Renaissance times. This area was also subject to change. During the Middle Ages, Sozopol was one of the biggest harbors in the first Bulgarian realm and was a center of shipbuilding. More than 80 of its houses and churches are now protected monuments, and the charm of the former fishing village is still visible in some areas. The coast is wild and rocky, and very popular with bathers. Now we travel into Bulgaria's interior. Close to Kazan Luk is the Valley of Roses. The mild climate favors the growth of delicate roses, whose precious oil is much in demand. Each year at harvest time, in the first week of June, the Rose Festival takes place, a world-famous attraction. harvest time is associated with ritual festivities. The valley's inhabitants dress in festive traditional clothing and celebrate in the fields with music and dance. Prayers and sanctification accompany the thanksgiving. Age-old traditions are very much alive here. Young girls and older women adorn their hair with rose blossom, dance and make merry. For many years, the people of this sheltered valley have earned their living from the roses that grow between the Balkan mountains and the Srednja Gora. The roses produce rosin oil, a liquid created by the pressing of rose petals, and in former times was considered to be as precious as gold. The petals are harvested early in the morning because when the roses are still moist from the dew, they retain their full aroma. Around 1,400 blossoms are required in order to produce 1 gram of essence following distillation. Hard to believe. To produce 1 kilogram, 3 tons of blossoms are necessary. Kazanluk is the main town of the valley. Here both wine and rose oil are produced, and there's also a market. Under the Thracians, there was a settlement here, and that's why the valley is also known as the Valley of the Thracian Kings. Rose oil and Thracian history, a great attraction for tourism. More than 12 Thracian grave mounds have been discovered in the environs of the town. Within the mounds are up to 12 meter in diameter burial chambers whose domed roofs are covered in paint. Following royal burial, the stone tombs were covered with earth and camouflaged as tiny hills. No other village in Bulgaria has retained such an original village atmosphere that features the character of a rural settlement of the 18th and 19th centuries. So, Kopfristica has become a protected monument, a kind of living open-air museum of rural architecture. It features more than 300 exhibits, dwellings, churches, fountains and bridges. An ancient historic village, tantamount to being a living past. Amazingly, everything here has remained intact, even though this was once the center of a rebellion against the Ottomans. The road across the Shipka Pass travels in a northerly direction. It was once Bulgaria's most important mountain pass, and within it is a memorial church. In August 1877, about 6,000 Russians and Bulgarians battled for 3 days against a huge Turkish force. In remembrance of many dead soldiers, the Memorial of Liberty towers into the sky, surrounded by old weaponry and with an overwhelming view from an altitude of 1,300 meters above sea level. Further north, Sokolsky Monastery is well worth a visit. In an idyllic location, it is situated on a rock wall amid a wild landscape. From Funded by donations, citizens from the nearby town of Gabrovo built the monastery in 1833. A pretty flower garden with a stone wall makes it easy to forget a dark event that once took place. In 1856, the Ottomans captured a group of Haiduk here. After the Bulgarian mercenaries were cruelly tortured, they were thrown over a rock wall into the abyss below. Near Gabrovo is the museum village of Itara that was inaugurated in 1964 and features some fine rural architecture. Within a narrow canyon, buildings and workshops from all over Bulgaria have been rebuilt in the traditional design of the National Renaissance. The museum is like a real settlement, with various buildings and mills along a small mountain creek. Various craftsmen go about their work. Weavers, bakers, woodworkers, and millers demonstrate their abilities. The 50 buildings in this village look just like the originals. They've captured each and every detail of the original 19th century settlement. The open-air museum was established in order to maintain the traditional craftsmanship of Gabrovo, skills that continue to be used today. Icon artists also demonstrate their work in small workshops. On the first floor are the residential rooms. Everything is just like the original, including both tools and materials. Many of the craftsmen's products are sold in the local shops. And freshly ground flour is used for baking bread. Veliko Tarnovo, the queen of cities, built on three hills, surrounded by forests and flanked by the meandering Yantra River. With its picturesque location, tangled alleys, beautiful architecture, and many historic sites, it's one of the most beautiful cities in Bulgaria. In the 12th century, the Boyar brothers, Peter and Asen, proclaimed the second Bulgarian realm, and the city became a powerful capital. For Bulgaria's national poet, Ivan Vazov, it was a dream vision. Zareva's Hill is crowned by the reconstructed and mighty Patriarch's Cathedral. With its sturdy outer walls, pillars and bell tower, it looks like a great fortress. The remains of the walls of the former Tsar's palace are located further down the hill. The palace is said to have measured 6,000 square meters. Even the ruins demonstrate how shining the realm once was, and numerous alleys and buildings highlight the city's former wealth. Palaces, churches, and dwellings nestle on terraces on the steep rock and protect the splendid works of art. the city continues to allure. A Tsar's city with its unique, harmonious and artistic architecture set within a beautiful landscape. Plovdiv is the secret capital of Bulgaria and, like Rome, built on seven hills. After the Thracians followed the Macedonians, then Romans, Huns and Slavs, and finally Ottomans. The city at the foot of the Rhodopes was settled for 8,000 years without interruption. Its character has survived. Plovdiv is an historic melting pot of both culture and tribes. The old town features buildings from many epochs. Such as the Roman theatre from the time of Marcus Aurelius that formed part of an acropolis. But most of the historic old town dates back to the 19th century. Cobblestone alleys, wonderful buildings, and wooden aureoles. The arts and crafts here are reminiscent of Ottoman rule, when Jews, Christians, and Muslims were allowed to practice their religions freely, and when both art and culture flourished. The Dzumaya Mosque is one of the city's few remaining Muslim prayer houses. Once, there were more than 50 mosques in the city. It features noble decoration and remarkable calligraphy. The densely wooded Rhodopes and its hidden monasteries frame the Thracian lowland, one of the most fertile areas in Bulgaria. The wild and romantic Rhodopes Mountains are situated in Bulgaria's south along the border with Greece and Turkey and running almost parallel to the Balkan Mountains. A landscape of wooded hills whose weather-beaten karst features strange-looking rock formations and numerous caves. This extraordinary primeval world attracts many hikers and cave explorers who enjoy the excitement of adventure. However, waterfalls and narrow canyons make the area almost inaccessible. The caves of western Rhodopes are the main destination for many of the region's visitors. Such as the Jagodina Cave that is 10 kilometres long and extends up to 5 levels within the limestone mountains. It's the longest and deepest of the Rhodopes, and its tunnels and huge galleries feature traces of prehistoric inhabitants. A wonder of nature. Rilski Manastir is the most splendid symbol of Orthodox Christianity in Bulgaria. It is the country's oldest and largest monastery. The facades and arches of the tall, several-floor monastery are painted with both light and dark stripes. The long buildings with wooden galleries and colourful arcades accommodate the monks' cells as well as a kitchen, bakery, cheese dairy and refectory. the magnificent Church of the Birth of Jesus stands proudly in the middle of the courtyard. A harmonious exterior that is created by various layers of colourful stripes, domes and arches. This impressive sacred place has stood here for more than 1,000 years. It was founded by a monk, a follower of St. Ivan Rilski, who lived here in isolation as a hermit with a life full of prayer. Also a hermit, Rilski turned against the Bulgarian Tsarist court and chose to live a solitary life. The three-level basilica is a splendid building surrounded by open arcades that protect a wall that contains valuable carvings and icons. These works belong mainly to those of the Samokov and Bansko schools of art. The 1200 motifs guide the faithful and warn them not to lead a godless life. The imagination of Bulgarian fresco painters such as Sashari Sograf and Stanislav Tospevsky seems to have no limit. From the walls and vaults, the paintings shine out in an almost fanciful riot of colour. A colourful world indeed, a magical place. Unique and highly valued fresco art, completed to perfection. Hidden beyond fortified monastery walls designed to deter thieves. The interior is a remarkable sight, with magnificent wall paintings and a 10-metre-wide gilded iconostasi. At the front there is a box that contains the nation's most valuable relic, the left hand of Holy Ivan. The church was designed to be decorative, colourful and full of detail. The birthplace of Bulgarian national identity, the Bulgarian Renaissance of the 19th century. The large monastery complex, whose red roofs and domes tower above the mountain forest, was designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1983. Rilski Manastir, Bulgaria's precious national treasure. In Melnik, the smallest town in Bulgaria, our journey comes to an end. It lies hidden within a valley between the rock ranges of the Pirin Mountains. The buildings were once packed densely above each other on the slopes, but today only about 200 people live here. Melnik nestles between steep rock walls of sandstone. Over the course of time, wind and weather have shaped the rocks into strange-looking figures. Among the numerous structures in the style of Rhodopes civil buildings is Karopilov House, once owned by a rich wine merchant. He showed off his wealth with two rows of windows, one on top of the other, and valuable paintings, carpets, and furniture. Labyrinth-like corridors lead from the house directly into the mountain and are used as a wine cellar. Since the 13th century, the local wine was the town's most important export and made its inhabitants rich. Thank you. Today, tourists come to admire the strange and pyramid-shaped sandstone formations. Bulgaria, on the border of both Occident and Orient. A country full of history and natural beauty, with authentic culture and overwhelming hospitality. A colourful mixture of fascinating tribes with a large variety of tradition, and according to legend, a part of paradise that God gifted to the Bulgarian people.